Have you been sitting still for too long? Well, don't worry, our next cube is going to change that. Our final presentation in this MCube Difference segment comes from a cube called Active Classroom. Team members include faculty and undergraduate students from the School of Kinesiology and the Taubman College of Architecture and Urban Planning. Get ready for professors Rebecca Hassan and Sean Vance with students Matthew Nagy, Molly O'Sullivan, Omari Tabor, and Trevor Tooley.
The world has stopped moving. Long gone are the days when physical activity is an integral part of our lives. We're no longer walking to school or work. We're usually driving in our cars or taking a bus. Long gone are the days where we are being very physically active at work or at school with the loss of PE or recess, or with us spending the majority of our time sitting throughout the day. As a result, we see that the epidemic of obesity has increased dramatically in the United States and across the world. And today's children are the first generation to have a shorter life expectancy than their parents. MCubed has given us an excellent opportunity to explore this question of childhood obesity and find innovative ways in which we can address childhood obesity from an architecture and kinesiology standpoint. My colleagues, Sean Vance and Milton Curry, along with myself and our team of students, are working together to understand how can we engineer physical activity back into children's lives using the classroom as our primary setting. We know that children spend the majority of their waking hours in the classroom, and this is an opportunity to use that environment and design it in a way that we can get them to be more physically active. Our architecture colleagues are focusing on how do we redesign that space to make that space more conducive to physical activity. And those of us who are kinesiologists are trying to understand what's a feasible dose of physical activity that teachers will be okay with implementing in their classroom, but that is short enough or has a short enough time frame so that the kids still have fun and that they can still reap metabolic benefits.
With the increased attention being given to childhood obesity, why is it that physical activities become so easily expendable from the school day, where children spend the most time? Well, with recent cuts to public school funding and an increased emphasis on standardized test scores, schools have been replacing physical activities such as recess and PE with more class time and test preparation in the hopes of improving this academic performance. However, there have been recent studies that have shown that lower fitness levels and lower physical activity are associated with lower test scores. So reducing the amount of physical activity in the school day not only affects a child's weight status, but also affects his or her academic performance. This is why it is so essential that we re-engineer physical activity back into the school day to improve the overall health and well-being of our children.
In an effort to engineer physical activity back into the school day, we have focused on the school environment where children spend most of their time. The top row shows efforts that have been worked on in the past, including active learning, playgrounds, and transport. The bottom row shows efforts that our team has focused on. From a kinesiology perspective, active breaks is the idea of getting up and doing short bursts of physical activity throughout the day. We specifically have been focusing on the effectiveness of 20 intermittent activity breaks, each lasting 2 minutes. This totals 40 of the 60 recommended minutes of physical activity each day and accounts for a wide range of benefits that we will discuss next. From an architectural standpoint, our team has focused on active hallways and classrooms. Active hallways is the idea of engaging regular room-to-room movement and making it more active and intentional. This includes ideas such as taking longer routes to classrooms, engaging in higher intensity motion, or integrating elements such as hopscotch or winding paths along the floor for children to follow. Active classrooms focuses on the actual class space and integrating elements that will promote and be conducive to more physical activity. The proposed classrooms have furniture, wall and floor elements, and furniture arrangements that will get kids moving.
So what are the potential benefits of incorporating 2-minute activity breaks and more active spaces into the learning environment? Well, we knew that there would be some obvious metabolic ones, such as lower resting heart rates, more normalized blood pressures, and our early research has shown that we can increase the caloric expenditure over a course of a week by 1,500 calories in these kids just by two-minute activity breaks alone. But we're exploring some other questions, such as what will the impact be of these studies on the kids' feelings? What were the psychological effects of these breaks? Here we expect to see that they'll have better mood states, higher appreciation for activities, higher enjoyment in the classroom, and we also expect to see lower anxiety and stress levels. Another question we're exploring is, what are the effects on academic performance? How will these interfere with the classroom activities? We actually expect to see that they'll improve their mental performance based on previous studies and the early work we've done. And lastly, we are curious to see the impacts as they translate out of the classroom. What behavioral effects will these activities have on these kids once they leave the school day? And we expect to see that they'll have a higher satisfaction for food, so they'll eat less in their daily diets. We also expect to see that they'll have a higher level of spontaneous physical activity. So not only will we increase their activity levels in the school day, but we hope to translate that to their lifestyles in other aspects.
The MCUBE funding has helped us study the appropriate tools architects can use that would be useful in clarifying the problem of physical activity in the classroom. Spatial organization, intuitive interaction, and environmental comfort have been incorporated into design of an active floor space.
The first level of speculation included zoning off the classroom into specific work areas and learning areas. Floor patterns allow movement and organized activities to be conducted around the room, and the coordination of the room by the teacher allows them to move things throughout the class day. The work areas and learning zones are defined by the desk and type and seek to specify physical movement along with work activities for throughout the day. The teacher can program the room for specific learning tasks in selected areas. RFID tags and GPS location systems encourage physical movement associated with assignment exploration. Movable furniture in storage areas allows for the relocation of the entire room's furniture systems based on the need and activity type. And an active wall system allows for a variety of activities when activities are related to projections on the wall or the wall is not in use. This allows stretching and the use of pliable surfaces, such as balance beam transitions. And another way of looking at the reinforcement of social furniture types, which incorporate a leisurely activity and allow for climbing throughout the room. And understanding that an active child is a healthy child, we wanted to understand more clearly what defines the field or territory in which we can analyze the body's range of motion and select activities and stimulate the levels of physical activity from high to medium and low in controlled environments.
So why is physical activity so important for our children and for adults? Well, we know that physically active, physically fit children turn into physically fit, physically active adults, that behavior can track over the lifetime. We also know that physical activity or physically fit kids tend to have a lower obesity risk, so this could help contribute to the declines in obesity that we're starting to see. We know that fitness is associated with 40% higher test scores, and children will engage in less risky behaviors if they are more physically active or physically fit. They are 15% more likely to go to college. Once they become adults, their disease risk for cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, is much lower, and that translates into a lower healthcare cost. And finally, some emerging research is starting to suggest that physically active, physically fit kids may actually live up to 5 years longer, increasing life expectancy. So it is imperative that we figure out ways in which we can engineer physical activity not only into the classroom, but throughout children's life. I'd like to invite you all to participate in a physical activity break now. One of our favorite physical activity breaks is a Just Dance 2-minute video, Eye of the Tiger. So if everyone can stand up, if you can put your laptops on the floor, stretch it out. I promise it's not too difficult. Let's get everybody up. Encourage your person next to you to get up if they're still sitting. Stretch it out. And let's go. I
passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight just to keep them alive. It's the eye of a tiger. It's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rival. And the last known survivor stalks his way in the night. And he's watching us now with the eye of the tiger.
Great job, everyone. Thank you. Ha ha ha.